what I was doing, YouTube Live, Facebook Live. Never know a land in the land of the rubber band. Yeah, this is Chief. We're at Waikoloa Baptist Church. Worship Hall. Hey, I do all the cleaning come Saturday. Before the service. And just to give you guys a feel of what I do, you know, cleaning the floors. Sometimes I clean the windows and stuff like that. And I just did this hall back here. You know, some of the guys in Facebook, you guys wonder what all I do over here. You know, I shared a little, you know, in pictures of what I've done. I just got through mopping this floor. And this room, when preschool isn't running, when it comes Sunday, these will have our coffee and refreshments and stuff. Snacks, we have snacks on the tables that are set up over there. And I do all the two tables out there I'm gonna bring in and put them up, and these other tables I'll leave for the people that come in and set up for the snacks. But yeah, been doing that. Another thing, I had shared on YouTube about my grinder. And I had recorded earlier today, and I went to Home Depot, and I exchanged the broken one for brand new. I checked this one out, no cracks, nothing. Good 4.5 inch. There was a 5 inch in there. And I do have a 5-inch wheel, and this thing can turn a 5-inch wheel. It has the torque and RPMs to do it. And it's only a 1/2-inch diameter larger wheel for grinding. I got some grinding. I would like to use a bigger wheel. It's a lot faster. More surface kind of stuff. Anyway, I got this done. Solution over here of water, pine salt, and a little bit of Clorox bleach. And what that does is it helps sterilize. And there's a way to do it where you don't get the fumes that can hurt you. And the way that's done is with water first, always water first. Fill up the bucket with water, and then you mix the chemicals in that. Same thing when mixing acid and water. You never pour water into the acid, you always pour the acid into the water. Same thing with this, just so you don't get fumes. The two chemicals will react by themselves. But anyway, give you guys a little feel of what old Chief does every Saturday. All of this, I do those back rooms back there. This hallway, got the kitchen over here. They don't cook in this kitchen. There's no stove. Well, we do have a refrigerator, we have sinks, we have cabinets in storage. One restroom, got a drum set over there. Hopefully we'll find somebody to play drums, you know, that'll join our congregation. We did have one, but the guy left. And this is the other. All our restrooms are either or. can't make one just for one, because we have, you know, sometimes we have over 100 people come. And this is the mess in the office. They're fixing it up, Trent and his wife Rebecca, our new youth pastor and his wife, good people, come to love this man. He's been doing a lot of work with our children, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on, and you know, our kids have a big challenge, you know, growing up, peer pressure and all that stuff, you know, you don't know anything about it. We do have a lot of improvements coming up, but as you can see, this leaves and stuff that blow into this place, can't help it. This place, the CB handle for this for Waikoloa is the Windy City. Believe me, it gets windy over here, brother. You know. This is another section they're working on. They just painted these walls. This is another part of Keiki Land, which is the preschool. Still got more work to do. You know, they still gotta do that cabinet, all that stuff. In there, they got all video DVDs. You know, they have this little setup over here for the kids to use the imagination. Like I said, there's a painting of this wall. Another restroom for the kids. You know, because this is a preschool. They gotta make the toilets for the kids. Easy for the kids to access. I gotta come in here and vacuum. There's a lot of dust on the floor. And Sunday, the kids do come into these rooms. And so I need to get this ready for the Kiki. For children. Oh, Keiki is a Hawaiian word for children, for child. It depends on how you say it, and where you put your kaako, which is a diphthong. It can be singular or it can be plural. Keiki. We don't say Keikis. You know that we don't have. We never end our words with a consonant. Not a place I gotta clean up. Look at that. Paper and all on the floor. A slightly unflushed toilet. More stuff on the floor. Some of this stuff I can't do anything about. Main thing, the kids have a play area. And what I'll do, I'll clean it up so they can get around. They won't be in this area, but they have this rug over here. For Sunday, they have a place to, where the aunties can help them with the with what they're trying to teach them. You know, they teach them all kind of stuff. You know, Bible stories, and the kids dance and stuff. Well, mostly like signing, that kind of stuff. And Auntie Pat is good at that. That lady is real energetic for her age. You know, I got a lot of good ohana in this church. Ohana, if you guys know, is the Hawaiian word for family, and ohana goes beyond the blood that goes through your veins. You know, also hanai, ohana hanai is the family that you choose, that you love, or the one that's not born to you. And you have ohana koko, ohana piko, you know, the ones that you related to true blood. true bloodline genealogy. That's why we use the word pico. Pico is the navel, but it has a lot more, it has a deeper meaning, pico. What we call kauna, or it's called kauna, hidden meaning. So, a lot of tables over there for when we have events over here. Yeah, the chief got a lot on his plate. You know, I try to take care of this. This is what keeps me going. You know, you guys that know me know that I'm disabled. I have a lot of injuries and stuff going on. And this is what keeps me going. You know, until I can get my machine shop going. And even when I get my machine shop going, I'll still be doing this. You know, I love this. You know, I love this church. I love the people. You know, not all of them Hawaiian. More Haole. You know, I don't use the other version called Haole. They say Haole, but it's not really the proper way to say the word Haole. Original meaning, ha, breath, ole, the first ha ole, they put the hand on, to shake hand. Hawaiians, we honi ihu, noses, we look in each other's eyes, we touch our faces, nose to nose, and we breathe in each other's breath. And that's how it was done. That's how they got their name, ha ole. And it has nothing to do with white. Although the first Haole, the king, were white. But it has nothing to do with color. But there were a lot of other people that were Haole without breath, besides white men. So, I try to keep everything perfect. I try to keep things correct, you know, everything correct. Correct meaning, yeah. Everything correct. You know, word will come from the mouth, gotta be correct. You know, politically, you know, correct. You know, I have my views. You know, I know there's been some disagreement between me and. One of the garage gang, you know who we are, but you know, one thing, when it has to do with my Mauna, with our sacred mountain over here, do not ever challenge me, because you will lose. You know, if you got a problem with me, you know, hey, invite you to come to the Hawaiian Islands and settle with me. Guarantee I will not call a cop, but be prepared what you're going to face with this old man. Even though I might be disabled, when I get in that zone, I don't feel pain. You know who you are. We were friends on Facebook. You unfriended me because of what I said. You have a personal problem with me, bring it. Otherwise, whatever. I don't hate you, but do not think that you come over here and fight with me. It won't go well for you. You cannot beat me. Believe me, I'm not talking crap. Anyway, let's get off that subject. As I said, the way I come to worship my God, what I believe, how I believe, between me and him, my other spiritual beliefs has to do with culture. Those of you that know me, and when I talk about the Mauna, you know, those of you in the garage gang who also have Facebook accounts, you guys know that I talk a lot about the Mauna and how sacred it is to us. If any of you a Native American, then you will understand why Chief is the way he is. You will understand. Today the Mauna is shrouded by cloud. A lot of cloud action today. Got some wind. Well, you can see part of the Mauna. And you can see the pimples on our top, and that's what we're fighting against. We are eventually going to push to have all those observatories removed from our mountain. Not that we anti-science. You know, science is good, education is good, but when it becomes desecration, then that's no good. Period. You know, I told the TNT guys, if they like doing TNT, try build them on a Vatican island in Italy. You know what I mean? Go build them outside the Vatican and see how far that can fly. You know what I mean? See how that can fly. You know what I mean? Not going to happen because the TNT, the 18-story building, the houses that telescope, it's going to totally mess up the skyline, and we cannot have any more construction up there. That mountain is a major aquifer for this island. You know, I've been challenged by many of these scientists, but they do not know me. They do not know my knowledge of that mountain. I have been over just about every inch of that mountain, and I know it is water. And it's exactly where they say it's not. So, whatever. And I do not do arguments very well. I'll end up hurting the guy. You know what I mean? I'll end up grabbing him in a hold, and I will hurt him. I'll probably cripple him. If not worse, you know, and that's how it is. So I tell people, do not challenge me when it comes down to my cultural belief, because you can get hurt. You know, Chief ain't no small guy. I might be only 5'5", but brother, I weigh over 200 pounds. You know, I can still break handcuffs. I can still bend tire irons. I can still knock one horse out in one whack. You know what I mean? Right in the jaw. Right below his ear. I can drop his ass with one good one. So, like I said, do not challenge me. Well, that's my little rant today. Well, yeah, I've been going through some stuff, so, yeah. My nerves are a little bit raw. But anyway. Getting back to the subject is this. The church, my grinder, got a good grinder, Milwaukee. So, with that, this Chief, aloha, white.